Welcome back to the SERS booth. Aaron Schulenberg here with Joe Skurka with BASF. Another, today has just been fantastic. Traffic through the booth, through the aisles. Everybody I've talked to is amazed. How's it going over at your booth?
It's fantastic. I mean, the traffic is unbelievable. It's busy. It's SEMA again. It's just the energy here is just through the roof. It's just an absolute blast. And they're keeping us all busy at the booth. And we're keeping everybody apprised of what the latest and greatest things are in the world of paint. So we're loving it. It's a great show for us.
So BASF, I know, has some big reveals coming up later today that I think are happening shortly, if I'm not mistaken, and some great press conferences. But in addition to all the things that you guys have as a company going on here at the show, BASF's also been a huge supporter of our education program for every single year that we've had it. I think you guys have been at that level, and we're so appreciative of the support that we get from companies like yours. What is it about those types of programs that you guys see value in being a part of here at the show and in supporting in general?
We see a need for, number one, two things. Number one, getting youth involved and people up to speed on how to do the repairs. But secondly, and probably more importantly, even the complexity of the vehicles is increasing dramatically every year. It's up and up and up. If you can't stay up with all of the newer changes, you're never going to be able to make it in this industry. So we believe in education is the only way that you're going to succeed in the collision repair industry. And we want to support that effort as best we can. And we think SCRS and with the RDE education is just doing a really nice job of that. So we're happy to be a supporter of that.
Well, I know on behalf of our members, I can't thank you guys enough. You know, it's not just here at the SEMA show that BASF supports education, though. I know that for one of our member shops, there are things that happen in the industry. And we had a member who actually faced some tragedy with an unexpected fire in their shop. And to no fault of their own, they did everything right to prevent those types of things, and yet they still faced it. And I believe if you and I were talking earlier that you actually, because of that specific activity, put together some education to try to address that, to make sure that shops were well informed of how to protect themselves and their employees and things along those lines. Did you want to talk a little bit about what you put together?
Yes, absolutely. I would really like it. And so that's exactly what happened is we have a tragedy and we look at it and say, where exactly are we, where are we doing as far as educating the body shops in general and people that are working with our products or other products for that matter, to make sure they're doing it safely. And so based on that, we put together a little bit of a presentation on in to address the specific case of fire, which is the core or the core problem, and how that starts, and specifically with static electricity, which I think is kind of a little bit of an unknown, fuzzy subject in the collision repair world. And so I just want to go briefly through some key points about that, and then from there, hopefully, encourage some people to take some further action on this topic, because it can be very, very serious topic. And so just to start with, there's as you know, there's three things required to have a fire. You need fuel, you need oxygen, and you need an ignition source. So in the case of a body shop, the fuel is going to be all the flammable liquids that you're working with constantly, day in, day out. Maybe you get used to it because it's so common, but that's a fuel. You have oxygen, obviously. The ignition can be static electricity. And here's the tricky part, I think, that gets a little bit ignored with a lot of guys, and myself included, when working around some of these flammable liquids. Static electricity is always present. We're here standing on a carpet. If you walk across this enough with your feet, you go touch something, zip, you get a little bit of an electrical shock. That's static electricity.
But it can come from anything, right? Your clothes, it can come from things you're wearing, you know, any of those things.
Absolutely. And the thing I think to point out that always was counterintuitive to me is that one of the things it can come from is just pouring liquids. So if you're pouring a liquid through the air, that's causing friction, which is causing static. So now you've got a charge that could be in a flammable liquid. If that gets grounded or it's not grounded and then it hits ground, the charge is going to go from that, create the spark, and it's going to ignite. And so this is really serious business. And again, I don't think it's common to come to the realization that it's liquid just pouring through the air from one container to another that's going to create static through a pipe. There's lots of examples of how it's going to be created. But I think this is the most appropriate for what guys do day in and day out in collision repair shops. And so you can't get rid of that. You can't stop that from happening. But there are ways to mitigate the spark part of it, to stop the static electrical spark.
So what are some of those things that you can do?
you need to utilize bonding and grounding. So anything that you're pouring into has to be grounded to a solid earth. Just like in a home electrical system, you have to have a good ground. Any containers that you're working with should be bonded to that ground so that there's always an electrical connection. So there's no place where the static charge can actually create a spark and cause the ignition of the flammable liquids. In a nutshell, that's about it. It gets pretty complex after this, or somewhat complicated in what exactly the connection should be, how thick should the wire be, how exactly should the ground be set up. All these types of details need to be looked into, treated very seriously, but there's other people that are experts at doing things like that. There's a number of industry organizations out there, that, including OSHA, National Fire Protection Association. There's for-profit companies that are at the SEMA show here, I'm sure, that'll come into your shop, and we'll just take a look at everything, and that's one of the things they can take a look at. Are things properly grounded? They're the best qualified to be able to suggest what the best method of mitigation for any of this type of thing would be, and I would strongly urge everyone to just take a look around. If you're not sure what to do, call someone who knows a lot about this topic and get it taken care of, because it can really become a real serious and situation, and really don't need that type of tragedy again.
And while they're looking for those types of companies, look and see if they support organizations like SERS or others, kind of the way BASF does, because I think there's a lot of great companies out there, and sometimes that's a good way to look for them and identify them, is are they involved, are they supporting the industry, and are they involved in their trade associations and things like that.
Yeah, good idea, good suggestion, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, this is where it all comes to complete full circle and helps the whole situation. So absolutely, good idea.
Good. Well, listen, I know you guys got a crazy schedule going on this week. I was by your booth earlier. Looked fantastic. A lot of really cool stuff. Joe, thanks as always for all the support you guys give to SCRS throughout the year, not just here at the SEMA show. Really hope you have a successful rest of your show. And we'll come back more later this afternoon and throughout the rest of the week here from the SCRS booth at the SEMA show. Thanks for joining us.